tip. Today, as part of OS assignment, I will be teaching process concept. So let me explain. So first, let me tell about process. A process is nothing but a part of program that is under execution. Next is heap section, next is data section and test section. So next section contains code that is executed. It contains the code or set of instructions that is need to be executed. Next, data sections contain all the global variable and static variable. Static variable has global and static variable. So each sections contains dynamically dynamic memory allocated variables. Suppose the program has dynamic variables, like variables whose memory is not completely defined. Suppose let's consider an array. Suppose an array contains an array of 100 is needed, and use only suppose 10 bytes or 10 memory locations. So the remaining 93 GB of page. So in order to avoid that, we use dynamic memory allocation. So now stack contains functions that are need to be executed. For example, in main function, suppose in main function, suppose there is another function called as sum or subtract or etc. That are stored in stack part of the process. So coming to next, what are the number of states in the process? So process states. There are basically 5 states. First one is new state. First one. Second one is ready state. Third one is running state. Fourth one is waiting state. And fifth one is termination state. So first, whenever the process is created, it will be in the new state. So whenever the process is created, it will be in the new state, and then the process is admitted into ready state, where it is ready for execution. Now the schedulers will select set of instructions, and then it will enter into running state with the help of scheduling set of instructions. So during execution of these instructions, if there is an interrupt that is occurred, then that is IO interrupt or any interrupt which can occur during running state. So then again it will come back into ready state. In the middle, it will assign, it will be the state of waiting, and when the interrupt is completed, it will come back to ready state. So after the process is completed its running, then it will go into termination state. It will exit. So now coming to ECB is nothing but process control loss, or it is also known as task control block. So every process saves its state in PCB. So it saves information of process. So coming to structure of PCB, so PCB has structure like this. First, if you have process state, then it will have process ID, then it will have program counter, then CPU registers, then CPU scheduling, next memory management, etc. So here, whichever the process, in which state the process is, it will be stored in process state. So the state of the process is actually stored in process state. It's every process has its own unique ID that will be stored in process ID. Then PC contains the address of next instruction that is to be executed. So next address of next instruction. Next, coming to CPU registers, CPU registers actually show the temporary values that came during the execution of program. It shows temporary values. So next, CPU scheduling. So CPU scheduling actually schedules the instructions that are executed. Suppose there are n number of executions, then in that which instruction is executed first, which should be executed the next. So CPU scheduling will do that. Next, memory management. So memory management, in this actually it shows the base and limit value of memory. The address. Utilization mode.